In these problems, we want to determine the trig function values using the unit circle. So if we sketch the given angle in the standard position, the point where the terminal side intersects the unit circle will give us all the information we need to determine these trig function values, meaning cosine theta is equal to the x coordinate, sine theta is equal to the y coordinate, and tangent theta is equal to y divided by x. So for 90 degrees, our initial side will be here. We'll rotate counterclockwise 90 degrees. So the terminal side of our angle will be here. So this ray will intersect the unit circle at the point 0, 1. So cosine 90 degrees is equal to 0. Sine 90 degrees is equal to 1. And again, tangent theta is equal to y divided by x. In this case, we'd have 1 divided by 0. 1 divided by 0 is undefined. Therefore, tangent 90 degrees does not exist. Let's take a look at some more examples. Here the angle is 150 degrees. Let's go ahead and sketch that in standard position and see where the terminal side intersects the unit circle. So rotate counterclockwise 150 degrees. That would be here. And the terminal side intersects the unit circle at the point negative square root 3 over 2, 1/2. So this tells us that cosine 150 degrees is equal to negative square root 3 over 2, sine 150 degrees is equal to 1/2, and tangent 150 degrees would be equal to y over x, or 1/2 over negative square root 3 over 2. So here we can multiply both the numerator and denominator by 2, or 2 over 1. So these 2's simplify out, and we're left with negative 1 over square root 3. So if we rationalize that, we'll have negative square root 3 over 3. Let's try one more. Here our angle is negative 60 degrees, so we'll rotate clockwise this time to here. So the terminal side of the angle would be here, and it intersects the unit circle at the point 1/2 negative square root 3 over 2. So cosine negative 60 degrees is equal to 1/2. Sine negative 60 degrees is equal to negative square root 3 over 2. And tangent negative 60 degrees is equal to y over x. So we have negative square root 3 over 2 all over 1/2. So again, if we multiply both the top and bottom by 2, or if you want 2 over 1, all the 2's simplify out. So we're left with negative square root 3 all over 1, or just negative square root 3. So as you can see, the unit circle is very convenient to determine the sine and cosine function values of these angles that have nice reference angles.